Hey, how y'all doing? Let's do it to it. And we'll get going. Excuse me. Oops. Oh, drat. What? Oh, drat. Okay. Okay. Let's do it to it. Thank you. Oh. Oh man, I didn't get a chance to even get my move in. Drat. I have to find out. Got 21 though, that's not bad. All right. Oh, what? That's not forcing enough? Are you serious? Cover. Ah, got it now. Okay, let's do it one more time. Come on, let's get one of these. Let's win one of these. All right. Let's see, check, yes. Oh man, that was close. Okay, let's do it. What? Hold on. Whoa. That's kinda. Let's get this one right. Oh. I didn't, gotta give it a second to think next time. Sorry, it's an itch there. Anyway, I'm better now. gotta love it when it's a pawn that you're checkmating with. Let's see here. Check. Check. Grabs a rook. Takes. Takes. The queen. Ah. So here, let me see here. There was a type of pattern that would have been played there. There's only one check-in spot, I see. Oh, what? No way. I restart that. Let's give that one more go. Oh, whoa, whoa. Hello. Oh, that is mate. Okay. Gotta stay focused. Let's see here, bishop takes d6. Check, c takes. Ah, it does work, because then the queen goes to e7. Come on, there we go, gotcha. Sometimes my mouse slips a little bit, it's like, no. Unless it takes. What? Take a look at that one. That one puzzles me. So if we come here, that threatens mate, so let's do that. Now we kind of take here. Now we take there. Oh, this threatens mate. I have to figure out if rook e1 check. Because if you grab the rook, then queen g, takes g7, check, king d6, check, there. Check with the rook. Let's go for it. There we go. Gotta have courage. Let's see some. Check. Ah, yeah, that would be bishop check and win. So this does win here. Doing good so far. So far, so good. I think I got it right here. There we go. Here. Just check here and then infiltrates there. Thinking that's it. This right here locks the position up and makes the rook have to move. And then that's checkmate. That's total poundage right there. You're crushing. Total ownage on that one. I mean, total winning on that one. Okay. Takes, takes, there, there, trying to figure out how to open up the position here, you know, for the bishop and knight battery setup. Here blocks up the position. I think I got it. It's this here. Yeah. How you doing? That's good. But I have a blessed day. Let's see here. Check on d5. Can it takes, okay, let me see here. Check takes. Check. There, and then mate. Check. See, h6. Let's see, what did it take? h6. Queen takes g6. Bishop g2. bishop there. Knight check. Knight attacks queen. Right back. So h takes g6, queen takes g6, king h8, queen h5 check. Queen h6, blocking. Now I'm going to take it. Now we have to decide. See, the only problem with coming here is knight there. But we might be able to play queen h6 though. Bishop g7, knight h5, but actually I'm thinking it may not be that, it may be here and then there, and then we are in deep trouble. Well, I guess we could play queen there, and then after checks. King there. See, that's the tester, is bishop g7. Then knight f5, queen d4, knight h6, check, king h8, bishop takes f7, wait a second, actually that wins material. Actually, it doesn't. Because that knight, then we cover. Oh, okay. Because if bishop g7, knight f5, there's really no more checks. Go towards a perpetual. King h8, queen h5, knight h6, actually probably queen h, well, knight h6, and I don't really see anything else that could be done at that point. Yeah, I'm gonna go king h8. We'll take a look at that to see. What we can try is rook takes d3, queen takes d3, queen takes g2, check, king takes g2. No, that doesn't work. That doesn't work. I forgot about the knight. That one knight on h5 really throws a kink in the works. Otherwise, we could actually play rook takes d3, queen takes d3, queen takes g2, king takes g2, and then knight takes f4, forking queen and king. That would win material, but not in this line because of the sweet, subtle... maybe. Maybe it does work because of... I think it might actually work. It's a double check at that point, isn't it? It actually might work. Yeah, I think it does work. I actually think it does work. It's a double check. That is the sitch with this. The double check actually works with knight takes f4 check. It's a double check. And therefore, you will be able to pick up the queen and have material advantage at that point. But do we want material? See, we're down. Oh, no, we're not down. We actually be up. Yeah. Let's do it to it. Yeah, that one was kind of a interesting one. You had to have seen the double check, otherwise you would have dismissed the move order. Of course, as we know in as chess players in our tactics, a double check check makes our opponent have to move, so they can't take our knight. So that's what you had to have seen. And thank the Lord Jesus we did see that, and I truly mean that. That is a blessing to be able to see that. Because I almost dismissed it as a line. Okay. Oh boy, so knight. Interesting, okay. Trying to figure out if two knights are better than a rook, because we actually have this move here. We have rook takes e8. Oops, takes e8. Rook takes e8. Rook takes d5. Not rook takes d5. Knight takes d5. Or is it rook takes d5? I think it is rook takes. I was right. Rook takes d5, knight takes d5, and then knight takes d5, takes d5. And I think we get two pieces for the rook, and the knight is covering important squares and everything for our, and we can even trap the rook, maybe. If the rook tries to infiltrate in via e2, our knight from d5 can actually retreat back to e3, protecting the c2 pawn, and therefore trapping the rook, and then the next move would be king f1, winning the rook on e3. I'm wondering if that's... I think we have to throw that move order in, and then if rook takes... because if we tried, I'll show you the line here. The rook's actually being attacked. If you played knight takes, the knight would actually come back here and take on the d7. The knight would actually come and take on d7, and I believe I think we're actually losing at that. I think we're down exchange in that line. We'd be actually be down exchange. Because if rook takes e8, rook takes e8, knight takes d5, knight would actually take on d7, and we would have two knights, and our opponent would have a rook and a knight. We'd actually be down an exchange. And then this way, takes, 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 we're good. It's all about, at certain levels of the puzzles, it's all about proper trading, training down your, putting, you know, working to see which one's best. And there's no way for, in that line, our the opponent to basically infiltrate into our position. And like what we showed is if our opponent did with the rook try to infiltrate into e2, our knight could just swing right back to d3. I think it was e3, and then protect the c2 pawn, and it's trapped. So that's why that actually works. Otherwise, it wouldn't actually work. But I know that Anon likes knights, so that's a cool thing about that. Vishonon. Okay. Let's see, did they take something? I just wanted to make sure. Oh yeah, they did take a pawn. Okay, now we gotta figure out if g takes f5. G takes f5, rook g3, king h8. Rook e8, rook takes e8, queen takes e8, it's mate. So now we have to figure out, do we go up the board? Huh. We may actually go up the board, I'm thinking. I think we actually go up the board here. We have to take this, I know, F5, because when they give us a gift, you take the gift. And then if rook g3, check, king f6, and we should be actually almost, we should be safe because the queen can't get to h4, which will give us enough time to get our pieces unwound and okay. Yeah, I think we should just take. Oh wow, the queen checked. Interesting. Gotta figure out, do we want, we can't go f4, f6 because queen h4. Do we want to go king h8? King f8, it does put us in the crossfires, crosshairs. Boy, let me see, King h8. Trying to figure out what can our opponent play here. Okay. Queen takes. No, that was still would be not a good move. King f8, rook takes f5, that puts the f7 pawn in a pin. Really, if there's king h8, there's not much that our opponent can really do. Well, they may play queen h4, trying to get rook h3 and threaten mate via that way, like something like this. If we try it here, potentially they can try that, and then try to swing this rook over and mate there. And it would kind of be a little, well, I guess we then could just play f6 at that, but then the queen could grab that with check. Boy, that would be kind of unpleasant for us. Let's see, king f8. Rook takes. Actually, rook can't take there. Let's say queen h4 again. Boy, this is a tough one to choose which spot to go to. So if we come here, queen takes there, rook slides over, and we actually have check there, and when he intercepts, we mate. So I'm thinking it's king h8. Yeah. Trying to figure out if rook c6 doesn't handle the problem. But then he's got rook there. And then h6. Yeah, I'm gonna go rook c6. I think that's H6 a playable move here. that potentially a queen there could be played. Then you have king check here. I mean, king g7, and it should be okay. Because even if the rook slides over, you can intercept there. Yeah, I'm gonna go h6. Wow. I'm thinking we have to play king h7 here. Boy, this is a deep one. King h7's huge. Because then if queen e7, we have rook c8 to c7. We actually can't do that, because if we played king h7, we have, he's got rook e7 at that point. Ay, ay, ay. Maybe it's just plain old rook g6. I'm trying to make that work, but man, this is a crazy opening, crazy for sure. Boy. This is a tough one. Rook's g6, rotates g6, check, king g7. Try king h7. I think it's king h7. Yeah. The other lines don't work. Queen, rook e8. Up. Let's see. Takes, pawn takes. Pawn push. There, pawn push, promote, rook takes, king takes, king, up, king, up, king, up, does it? King up. King over. King up. Pawn promotes. Takes. Takes. King up. And there. There. Actually, I think the only way to win is to maybe retreat back. I'm thinking that might be the only way. Let me see. King G7. King D7. Check. Actually there, that should win. So King G7, King D7, King F7, and that wins. The only way to win was actually to stop the pawn with the king and rook. So Queen E1 check, King H2. Bishop intercepts, then bishop takes h3. That's really strong. Ah, that does, it wins a queen check here, king up, and that actually, I'm thinking potentially almost wins a, that almost wins a queen, almost. Let's see if we check. Let's see, e2. Oh, thought for sure e2 would work. That's okay, we'll call it on that. Not a problem. Why does, hold on, that one. Okay, just take there. Oh, we can't because of the rook, okay. It's one of me, that was an interesting. So sorry about that, I was moving too fast there. Here, there, and there. Let's try that one more time. Here, there, and there. Perfect. And then this one, really interesting. Let's give it one, let's go through them one more time, and then one that I gotta say I do, because you always want to, you know, get these in your mind. Okay. Okay. Let's do this one here. Get to see what our puzzle score was. I'm hoping we get, we got first. Hip hip hooray. We're number one, Team Chess Cruncher. Great job. Great job, Team Chess Cruncher. Thank you for participating, coming on, viewing. I hope you enjoyed. If you like it, click follow and join us again tomorrow. Remember what Bruce Lee said, that knowing is not enough, you must apply and you got to be willing to do something with it. But choices, and the choice to receive the Lord Jesus as Lord and Savior of your life is a vital choice. We all got to decide one day what we're going to do with the Lord Jesus. Bruce Lee also did say that if you will reach a plateau, and if you can go beyond the plateau, you should always strive to. And never be satisfied for second place, because on the seals it's first loser. We always got to remember that it pays to be a winner. I always have to remember that you get to be number one sometimes, and congratulations on that. But let me see here. Oh yeah, and the Team Chess Cruncher motto is what we as Team Chess Cruncher believe, is that we hang up our coats, we hang up our hats, we sit down and study when most won't. Team Chess Cruncher does, and that makes all the difference. And as Wesley so says, serve the Lord Jesus. As I say, God bless. And I'll see you next time on Chess Cruncher TV. Have a blessed morning, afternoon, evening. Lord willing, I'll be back on tomorrow, and we'll keep pushing forward. So, you gotta always remember what Hannibal Smith said on the A-Team. There's even inside of a random position, there's always a plan, And when you find it, you get to say, I love it when a plan comes together. Okay, two thumbs up, hoorah, be blessed, Team Chess Cruncher. Keep studying, having fun, and improving. And I'll see you tomorrow. Be blessed. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.